All right, so we're on the Windsor and Hantsport, just west of Hantsport at mile 38.73 of the Halifax subdivision. Headed railway west to do some exploration. This particular line has been out of service since 2007. So as you can see, nature has reclaimed it.
You need some of those pole climbing spike things to put on your boots.
Yeah.
And like, I guess you use a leather belt.
I have a leather belt.
To go like with their hands around the pole and then have the spikes on the boots.
Yeah.
Or a really long ladder.
A really long ladder would be beneficial.
Coming with a cherry picker.
That's just getting costly. That is getting expensive.
Awesome.
Yes, magic mushrooms. The magical goodness of mushrooms.
Are you there yet?
No.
No?
No.
Looks like a few people have been making their way down here.
Probably, yeah.
We found some insulators. Telegraph line. And there's a dragon in the woods trying to knock down part of the post so he can salvage the insulators. Hopefully without injuring himself.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't try this at home.
Looks like we're in some kind of a tropical rainforest with these really interesting trees. Oh, you got her now.
Yes, I do.
What's it stuck on?
What?
What's it stuck on? Must be one nail left or something.
Stick to swing that door open so we don't have to go into the thorns.
What do you mean you need a stick? You need a stick right here. You get it?
Yep.
Good?
Yep.
Anyway, folks, we just came up to the end of the track. This is where the line stops.
We just passed mile 39.
Yes. Mile 39 and a little bit. That's it. Now we are walking on. They must have took the tracks to do some repairs elsewhere. How far up do they take, did they take them out?
I have no idea. I'm wondering how far we am from the Blue Beach crossing, that bridge that you went on there in the summer. Remember that?
That is a good question. So there's no tracks for... Yeah, as you can see, they ripped them up. This Windsor and Hantsport must have tore them up not long ago.
There's a few walkers on this section too.
Yeah. What did they do with the rails? Yeah, because further up the tracks pick back up and they continue.
Uh-huh.
We know that. That's good ballast.
Yeah.
Here's where the tracks come back. So a whole section of rail has been taken up.
Maybe it was a local entrepreneur who wanted some money to scrap.
Well, he's not getting these.
Saving those for future archaeologists.
Yes.
200 years from now.
That's how we preserve rail lines. Oh, gotta save that. It's a 100-pound rail. Beautiful. This is a good spot to take a little rail cart down. Go for a nice cruise, field. Come up here, just bring it up to there, that little area, and put it on this and go.
Rail bike. Something that's light, because you've got sections where the rail is missing.
Well, missing.
It's got to be really light to be able to pick up and move.
Oh, it's only about 50 meters. You know, if somebody came out here with a buck saw, cut all this back. That's pretty steep down there. Now, this section was abandoned 2007. That's what you said, right?
Well, they stopped using it in 2007. I wouldn't say it's abandoned.
Yeah. Of course, like... Well, usually when we talk about abandoned, we're just... We're just referencing unused sections of track, not necessarily abandonment.
We are somewhere past mile 39. Haven't seen a mile marker for a while, so not exactly sure where we are now. But it is very scenic.
Eyes down there, different things like that.
No trains, but it's still a pretty view. What we have here is the endangered dragon eye species in his native habitat of the abandoned railway line. Very reclusive, only comes out at odd times of the year and of the day. Now where's my elephant shotgun?
Than I am.
We're back at mile 38.73. Yes, okay. Oh, well, that would explain why we only went a mile and a bit. Because we started out at mile 38.73, and we got to mile 39, and we went a little past that. So we didn't go nearly as far as we thought we did.
No, we only went like 2 kilometers.
Yeah. Here's the signal box. And we're going to go towards Hantsport to the east and see what we can find. Found some ties here. See what we can see. See if there's any date nails. Yeah, that's what I'm looking for. There's gotta be some date nails in this junk. This tie plate. Dragon Eye found himself another telegraph post in there, but can barely see it from the right-of-way. And this is the right-of-way here, and you can see just how much it's grown up. Unreal. But 9 years worth of growth. I think there was a power winch on this thing. So then they hook up a cable and then winch the cars along.
Not much left of it. Yeah, the main line's gone. Yeah, the switch is still there.
What they did here is they put the trail on the siding that went to the feed mill, and you're on the main line.
Yeah.
And this switch was to go into the potato chip plant.
Used to.
Yeah.
Still got the old lock there. They took the thing off. So yeah, I don't think this goes down too far.
No.
Yeah, they tore up the rest of the tracks up to here. Oh, that's rail. That's it.
Oh. That pile of rail down there.
Yeah. Well, there's some rail still here. Oh, he's gonna drag. It's a rail for it. What's left of it anyway? Yeah, that's all the rail they cut out that scrapped it. We are currently in Kentville on the heading towards, on the left is where the roundhouse used to be. Now it's a senior citizen's home. And this is the line towards...
This is the old Kingsport subdivision.
Yes.
So this was the Kingsport spur, which was in use, well, it was abandoned in 93. Might have been out of use a few years before that, but it used to be a part of the old Kingsport sub when that, and that was abandoned in 1961. So this is pretty much the last remaining piece of railway in Kentville.
Yep. Everything else has been torn up and there's not much left of it.
It's the Cornwallis River there.
Signs or something down there.
It's been redecked.
Yeah, it looks good. Oh, I thought those look like a couple of ties. Yeah, these are some of the original ties.
Yeah.
There's a track spike right there. Spike.
Supposed to come back in daytime. It's probably not going to look very good on video at night.
Actually, it doesn't look too bad, honestly. Don't forget this camera can pick. Yeah, see. I'm still getting good picture.
It's a pretty neat picture on the wiki of the flood. I think it was in the 30s, and they had parked a steam locomotive on this bridge to keep the bridge in place. The river was pretty high at the time.
Well, folks, there you have it. I think this is going to be it for today. We're losing light fast, and there's not much more we can really record.
Looks like the town's doing a good job of keeping the spray paint covered.
Mm.
That's good.
So anyway, until next time, this is Lord Dragon Eye and Maritime Rail Fan.
Keep fit and have fun.
Yeah, whatever he said. Pretty good camera for night time. Ugh.
can't see anything now, you can't. Oh, they still have the crossing signs up there.
Yeah, this condo thing was built when I lived here. And they had put in a whole new crossing set up at the street down here.
Yeah.
You don't remember this.
What?
This thing.
These? Yeah, those are new. Wonder why they put those in.
They were probably put in when this was built.
Yo, this would be great to run like a little pump cart down. Because I mean, yeah, you could almost run this, you could run a speeder down this very easily. And it goes for quite a ways.
Take them from there. It's in from back here, isn't it?
Yep.
fresh air at all. You can go from the stands to here and come from here and put them on the stands. That's how we do it. Because some of these locomotives look pretty heavy, you know, 3/4 of a ton.